Yeah.
Okay, that's just off my phone. Drive on the right side. Yeah, it's actually really hard to do off the phone. One sec. I'm going to find a cable for this.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, here we go. We got bigger speakers here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, turn it up a little, though, please. Thanks.
Ride on the right side. Drive on the right side. Ride on the right side, live on the left side. West Coast got a rep, got a rep, so I better step right. Gotta keep it tight. Trying to what tonight? Okay. Damn okay. Damn okay. The back of your head is ridiculous. Crazy is craving it is so conspicuous. Looking so sick, it be looking so simpless. And God, there's no kids in this. As God is my witness. Don't know where my wit is. No hope for that mixed kid. The riskiest business, putting your trust in your hope and your dreams in that bitch shit. Get this, said 12 o'clock and it's 9:30. Not a fucking word, that's by design. Now sly be sly, coy be coy, gaslight. That's right, drop that like a sack in the back of a long day grind. Shoot text ain't by, ghost of time right back. I don't have the motherfucking time for you crap. If you wanna connect, then call me back. Cause I ain't been treating this like a double tap. Bounce back, yeah, back cast doing fat raps. Then a fat rap spot license, drinks is back. Have a tic tac, bring it on, snap faster. You gotta own the hits. That's pretty much all I got so far for
yeah,
that one.
Yeah, I had a few things. Sorry, I'm really fucking tired too.
But no worries.
So like the song you're showing, I mean, even though obviously you have like the same, really similar lyrics, you know, like you kind of turned the song is now something different because you picked a different beat, right? It's a really different beat. Because the one before we were doing was almost like a trap one, right?
I think it was Don't by Bryson Teller.
Yeah, and now it's more like, laid back, obviously, right?
Yeah.
So, and this is actually reminding me of a different song from a few months ago you were doing that I can't remember what it was. But it was the same kind of thing where you started out rapping, then moved to singing, and then moved to rapping. I can't remember what it was called, though. Do you know the one I'm talking about?
Sucker for Pain?
Yeah, it was right around the time we worked on that one, I think. But anyway, that doesn't matter. All right, yeah, so, like, the thing is, like, okay, so where do you start singing? Right around here, right? Looking so syphilis?
Yeah.
And then you go back to rapping around. No hope for that mix kit. No, the riskiest business. Putting your trust in your hope and your dreams. That's where you go back to rapping, right?
Yeah. And I think I might even cut that together with... So, like, record that part, stop, cut the next part in with myself, just so that I have time to come in even faster.
Yeah, exactly. And that's kind of what I wanted to talk about now, anyway, is it's like, you have too much rap in too short a time here. Like, there are physically just too many syllables. You know,
okay.
So it's like we could even talk about Chance's stuff a little bit, because, like, what would you say?
I could take out a syllable by changing pudding to put.
See, actually, I think you needed to do two things. So let's just take the singing part. So let's just assume that this is the singing part, the thing I did. So the thing is, you need to, I guess it's like a consideration of musical space, right? Is that when you're singing, your rhythms are simpler because they're slower and they're more directly related to the beat behind you. But the thing is the pitch, right? And so the pitch, so pitch becomes more important when you sing. You know what I mean, right?
Yeah.
Like the, whether your voice is down here or up here, you know, but the thing is you, so, and because pitch is more important, you can't have the same amount of rhythms as you do in a normal rap where the pitch isn't as important. So it's like, imagine this, right? Imagine that someone is singing, but they're trying to sing with lots of different pitches. And they're going like, looking so syphilis, looking so sick, it be looking so syphilis. Thank God there's no kids in this, as God is my witness. Don't know where my wit is. You know, like, it sounds kind of weird, right?
Yeah.
Because I'm moving through the pitches too quickly. So obviously your rap wasn't as bad as what I just did. But it's along the same spectrum of, like, because pitches are more important now, and pitch needs more, every new pitch needs more time, you have to give each pitch more time, right? So it's
okay.
Like, if you're going to sing, then you really got to sing, and you got to go 100% in on singing. So let me think of a Chance song where he goes back and forth between rapping and singing.
Can I show you the, I just sent the original song. He does something similar, actually, in this one.
To you?
Yep.
All right, yeah, let me check it out in a second. Because you were like, I can take out syllables. And so, actually, to this part, there's one of two solutions. And then I'm going to listen to the original Chance song. Because if I had to guess, he's probably singing at this part, but it's like a sentence thing. His sentences are probably longer. So you need to either lengthen your, keep sentence length the same, but remove as many syllables as possible, or lengthen the sentence length to be one bar instead of, I think, because right now, I think they're just half a bar.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, yeah. If I had to guess, not knowing this song, Chance probably takes us at least one sentence per every sentence.
He does go into more than one bar. It's actually, I think, continuous for two or three bars.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. So let me think of one. Hold on.
Like blessing, chisel me into stone, prayer with fame as I get swinging. I'm in heaven, I know them for everything. I'm the breath. In my lap, all in my lap. It seems like blessings keep falling in my lap.
Let me count the beat.
Seems like blessings keep falling in my lap.
All right, so yeah, again, like he's singing, right? Because he's picking out individual pitches. So he's like, it seems like blessings. Sorry, I'm not a good singer. It seems like blessings keep falling in my lap. All right, so I'm going to call that... So he took six beats there, right? He took 1.5 bars. And this is what I'm talking about, is that when you're singing, every pitch becomes more important. And because every more pitch becomes important, you have to give the listener time to, like, catch up with you. Because now the listener isn't just paying attention to your words and your rhythms, they're also paying attention to your words, rhythms, and pitch. And because the listener has more information to, like, pay attention to and take account of, you need to slow it down for them so they can catch up. Let me listen to the original one, the link you sent me.
Yeah, you can skip to the chorus part.
Here's to the
okay, yeah,
game.
Do you know what time
to
stamp?
To the growers of the sod.
I think it's the first part.
Okay.
To the makers of stadiums.
My mama think I stink. I got burn holes in my hoodie.
So
my homies think it stink. I miss my cocoa butter kisses. My mama think I cigarettes on cigarettes. My mama think I stink. I got burn holes in my hoodie. So my homies think it stink. I miss my cocoa butter kisses. Cigarettes on cigarettes. My mama. Cigarettes on cigarettes, my mama think I stink. I got burn holes in my hoodies, all my homies think it stink. I miss my cocoa butter kiss.
Yeah, like, everyone there is still about four bars. And also, he's repeating the same pitches. So then it becomes easier to keep track of, right? It's just dun 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 dun. So he's kind of not singing as much as you are because he hasn't picked as many different pitches. And also, the important thing also that you can't really discount is the fact that he starts off his song like that. You know, which again...
Yeah, I was thinking about putting an intro in, actually.
Yeah.
Or just putting the chorus in first.
Yeah, yeah. And we've talked a lot about intros to songs, but it's like you really can't undersell just how important the intro to a song is. Because you're telling... Because the very first thing you tell a listener is everything against which they're going to compare it. So maybe if you had started your song off in that way with these really quick sung lines, maybe then it would carry. But as of now, moving from rap to singing... Right now, it's too much of, like, you're singing like you're rapping, which is a bit of a problem, you know, because it gets back to the pitch thing. So that's why, and again, his sentences are longer, even though he's singing, you know, each one takes up about a bar, and yours are, when I counted them, I think they were half a bar. So it's like, this is what I'm talking about, is that it's almost like a continuously moving, like, scale or slider, where like the x-axis is how quick your rhythms can be and y is how much singing you are, and there's like a straight line between them kind of that you have to follow, you know. So that's why I still think those two solutions hold, right? Because you have to, yeah, it's why those two hold. So it's like, yeah, you could keep your sentences the same being half a bar now, but then you have to remove as many syllables as possible. Or you could lengthen the sentences to be a whole bar long instead of 0.5 bars. So do you mind doing the whole thing again just so we can then get to the specifics of one of those solutions?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Thanks, man.
Drive on the right side, ride on the right side, live on the left side. West Coast got a rep, got a rest, so better step right, gotta keep it tight. Try to what tonight? Okay, damn okay. Damn okay, the back of your head is ridiculous. Crazy is craving, it is so conspicuous. Looking so sick, it be looking so syphilis. Ain't God, there's no kids in this. It's God, that's my witness. Don't know where my wit is. No hope for that mixed kid. The riskiest business, putting your trust and your hope and your dreams in that bitch shit. Get this, it's at 12 o'clock and it's 9:30. Not a fucking word, that's by design. Now slide be sly, coy be coy. Gaslight, that's right, drop that like a sack in the back.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's good. Just do the opening again. Actually, do the opening.
Like the very first part?
Until you start rapping again after you've just been singing. So, like, just that part.
Okay.
Just that part again. Do exactly what you just did. That amount.
God is my wit and... Oh, wait.
Oh, no. Start at the start, though.
Okay. Ride on the right side. Drive on the right side. Ride on the right side. Live on the left side. West Coast got a rep, got a rep. So, I better step right. Gotta keep it tight. Trying to what tonight? Okay. Damn okay. Damn okay, the back of your head is ridiculous. Crazy is craving, it is so conspicuous. Looking so sick, it be looking so syphilis. And God, there's no kids in this. As God is my witness. Don't know where my wit is. No hope for that mixed kid. The riskiest business. Putting your trust in your hope in your dreams and that bitch shit. Get this. The 12 o'clock
okay,
and it's
okay,
half
yeah.
past.
Yeah, cool. Thank God there's no kids in this. As God is my witness. Don't know where my wit is. Yeah. Hold on, let me go back to the original thing. Alright. So, yeah, because actually that new time you did it, I think you delivered it in a different way. You delivered it with more pauses in between the sentences, and that worked better.
That's the way I usually do it.
Okay.
Yeah, just early morning stuff.
Yeah, because I think before you were doing, like, thank God there's no kids in this, since God is my witness, don't know where my wit is, no hope for that mixed kid, like something a little quicker. Yeah. So basically what I was, yeah. So, okay, that's also another good solution, is just to add pauses until you line up with the bars, which is a lot of what Kanye and Chance do anyway. So, I don't know. Like, if you deliver it like you just did, I think that works pretty well. Then the only thing is, there's a couple fucking things here. You have a lot of different flows in this rap. So the one thing is, I really don't know if this beat works super well for the flow you have. Because, like, the triplet thing is, like, a little too hard. Like, it goes a little too fast for the beat to me.
We're going to totally remake the instrumental with instruments.
Okay, yeah.
So we can kind of tailor that towards...
Yeah,
I told the drummer, I was like, oh, yeah, you know, in the fast parts, you can just actually pause and just come in on the beat only and leave some parts out.
Yeah. Yeah, actually, what I was feeling in the beat there was actually him backing you up with more action.
Yeah, I guess he could hit it on the beat, too, with the drums as well.
Yeah, or even, like, a lot of, like, cymbals and shit like that to build, mm-hmm. really, like, a fucking...
Like Russian or something like that?
Yeah, exactly. Like a lot of cymbals, like a lot of sound, you know, like a lot of, a wall of sound. Yeah, just something fun, because it's like, this connects to my second thing, is it's like, and actually I've been talking to another dude I give lessons to a lot about this, is it's like, it comes down to where we are in this song, right? And part of the reason, it's not that switching your flows is bad, and you know that I'm always trying to gonna support like more innovative songs, more innovative stuff like this. But it's like, the listener has to know where you are in the song. So it's like, when you switch from, you know, so like, right here, and these are like, okay, these are all your flows, right? You've given us almost maybe like 3 or 4 different ones. Like, that's like a pretty standard, well, that's one flow, which is a standard one. This is a flow with a lot of pauses. Then this is a flow with,
The okay part, I get my drummer to say okay, so it's actually two people doing that part.
Pause is
the same and everything, but...
Okay, yeah, I mean, that's still different than if two people are doing it, and then, you're singing here, and then you go back into your normal one, which is fine. But the thing is, like, but then we don't know where we are, and obviously, one of the two places we should be is the verse or the chorus.
Yeah.
So, when you keep switching up, like, when Chance sings, it works because we're like, okay, that's the chorus. And when he raps, it's fine because it's like, okay, that's the verse. Which is fine because he's not trying to push boundaries as much as you are here. Because he's got two different flows, right? Singing and rapping. Here, you've got, like, 4 different ones, right? So, if I could show you...
And they do switch it quite a bit. Just because, like, he has two other people on the song.
Yeah. See, exactly. But then the thing that we know he switches because he does it after 4 bars, after 8 bars, after 12 bars, or after 16 bars. But, like, right now, you're kind of, the feel I was getting was that you're changing at, like, the 10th bar. Which is fine, but then you have to even it out somewhere else, like in the beat. You know, so if you're going to switch flows at the 10th bar, then the beat has to switch too at the 10th bar. So it's like, you should ask yourself sometimes, what's like a fucking, here, let me play a Jean Grey song I know you don't know. What's that fucking guy's name? All right. Here, I'm going to play you a song, it's called Believe. You don't know the song, do you?
No.
Okay.
I haven't heard.
And I want you to tell me, I'm just going to drop you in a random place in the song, and I want you to tell me whether it's the verse or the chorus. Is that the verse or chorus?
Uh, That sounds like the chorus to me.
Yeah, exactly. And it is. So, okay, yeah. And I'm going to do this again. What's another Jean Grey song? Yeah, why does it feel like the chorus?
I think it's mostly the instrumental, but also because they're using that flow that's kind of like it ends on the beat.
Yeah.
Like it ends at the end of every bar kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly. Her flow is simpler. Basically simpler. Because, like, you should think about why they call it a fucking hook, man. They call it a hook because of it's what hooks you into the song, and in order to hook you into a song, it has to be able to be remembered. And in order to be able to be remembered, it has to be on the simpler, catchier side. So that is why hooks are hooks and verses are verses. So, like, another one is, like, what could we do? Alright, was that a verse or a chorus?
Sounds like a verse.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, see, and this is what I'm talking about, is that these rappers know how you understand, how you hear, how their listeners hear music so well that they always keep them oriented. You know,
yeah.
It's almost like when I hear your song now, it's like I got dropped in the middle of New York City and someone was like, okay, get to California. And I'm like, well, say I don't have a phone. But like, and it's like, well, how the fuck do I get there? I don't know which direction I am. I don't know how to get to the airport. I don't know where the subway is. You know, so it's like the verse and chorus are like your orientation. So again, it's always like a moving thing, right? Because I'm not telling you to just only make verse a 16-bar verse, and then an 8-bar hook, and then a 16-bar verse, and then an 8-bar hook, and then an outro, and the song's done. But, like, you have to keep them into it, you know? Because it's like, here, let me play you an Eminem song where he really changes the, and this matters because loops in rap are 2 bars and 4 bars long. That's the important thing. So you know Rap God, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. I want us to listen from the last hook until when he starts rapping really fast. And I'm going to tell you how many bars happen before he starts rapping really fast. Because it's going to be a multiple of 4. I don't even know what multiple of 4 it is. But just, Eminem knows this too. Because he's a good rapper. So, like, the loop is 2 bars long, right? It's that... So then Eminem knows that his important changes have to happen at 2-bar sections. So we're going to listen to the verse and then get... Because, you know, the really... the part where he starts rapping really fast, where it's like... Sumaluma, dumaluma, I'm assuming you're a superhuman, whatever. And that's going to be multiple, too. Because he does it at that 2-bar break. He does it after a multiple of bars that's divisible by 2. Because then he won't lose you.
Zombie floating, but I got your mind be broken. I'm at my vomit, it's nothing in common. People on the dome,
sent yourself in New York and patience is beautiful to me. My eyes is crucial, but it's honestly futile if I don't utilize what I do, though, for good at least once in a while. So I want to make sure somewhere in this shit's got time to come and do them and just sign stuff. Maybe try to help get some people through tough times, but I gotta keep a few punchlines just in case believing you punchline. Man, it's a hungry looking at me like it's lunch time. I know there was a time where one time was king of the underground, but I still dance like I'm on my fair own punch lines, my crunch lines. But sometimes when you come find a man with a skin color of mine, you get too big and hit a punchline. Got a sense of you like that one line I said, oh, no, man, from the man, there's LP1 when I'm trying to sell. Take seven kids from Kyle, I'm trying. Put them over the line at an AK-47 and revolver and another nine. Let's see if I get away with it now that I ain't as big as I was, right? Send it to an immortal coming through the portal. You're stuck in a time warp from 2004. Don't you know what the fuck did you find for? Your pointless is Rapunzel with fucking cornrows. My normal for being normal. And I just bought a new ray gun from the future just to be a teacher. Like when Tabitus made JJ mad. His pants ain't even looking fat. And they were chats and into a man on the JJ. Yeah, no man, oh man. That was a 24/7 special on the cable channel. So AJ went straight to the radio station the very next day. Hey, Fab, I'ma kill you. Lyrics coming at you with supersonic speed.
See, so like, it's like Eminem is preserving the structure of the song's chorus. So even though he's introduced this really radical, no, I'm sorry, he's preserving the structure of the song. And so even though he's introduced this really radical flow change, we don't get lost because he's following the playbook, kind of, you know? Let's say the hook is four bars, right?
Well, what I'm confused about is mine, if you count each of them as a full bar just because of the pause.
Yeah.
Where is it? I'm just looking through the lyrics here. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, it's like six bars.
Wait, where? In the chorus?
Yeah. Well, no, for the singing part, it's about six bars.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. It's like you kind of got to iron out some of those edges. So it's like, it should really either be four bars or eight bars. Because that's
okay.
Because that's how most loops in rap are structured. So like, this is the thing. You can have all these flow changes, but they should either happen at the fifth bar, the ninth bar, the 13th bar, you know, because it actually turns out to be an odd number of bars because it's like not an inclusive counting system, you know? So when I say you start at the fifth bar, you're actually at moment one after four bars have passed. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So that's what I'm saying, though, is like when you, I wish I could fucking have a fucking recording of you and the beat behind you, because I could point out how these things aren't lining up right now. So it's like, you need to bring your singing into alignment with the bars of the beat. It's kind of what I would do. And then it's easier to vary that rather than to come up with an on-the-spot variation on a four-bar structure right away. So it's like, what I would do if I were you was, I would... All of your flows are awesome, and you actually flow from one to the next really, really well, especially into and out of the singing. But what I would do is either lengthen or shorten each of your four flows so that they next last for an amount of bars that is divisible by four, and that lines up with the repeating loop behind you. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So then it's like, make, you know, because a hook lasts for eight bars, right? Or whatever. But now make all of your flows the hook. Make the flows your hook. So like, sing for eight bars. Do triplets for four bars. Then go back to your normal rapping for however many bars, you know? Because that's what these rappers are doing. It's just that they haven't decided to do it in such a small amount of space. Is that making sense?
Yeah.
Because check this out, man. And this should fucking blow your mind. Because Kendrick rigor mortis, we've talked a lot about it. But it's like, I'm gonna tell you what bar he comes in on. 11. That's wrong. He came in on the wrong bar. He came in on the 11th bar. So now it's not, oh, Kendrick's a bad rapper. I have to know, like, how can Kendrick fix this? Right? Because he came in on the 11th bar, which is the exact opposite of what I'm telling you. So, because now, if he raps for four bars, he's still in the wrong place. It's the 15th. And the loop here, the loop is two bars. Absol made the beat, I think. So, I know that choruses are four bars, right? So now it's like, well, how is Kendrick going to get himself back on track? How is he going to put himself back at the 17th bar, right? Because if he only raps for four bars, then he's short, because he'll be at the 15th bar. But if he raps for eight bars, then he'll go too long. He'll be at the 19th bar. And he's rapping the chorus, and choruses don't last for six bars in rap, right? So it's so like...
he goes for a 10-bar chorus, I think.
Well, this one is weird. I honestly can't get into it. It's too complex. So it's like, it turns out that his chorus is made up of 12 bars, but he's...
Oh, it's 12?
Well, here, dude, the structure, okay, the chorus is really 16 bars, but the chorus only happens once. The real chorus only happens once. So you have to ask yourself how that happens. And that's because it's in an A-B-A-B form. So... And so he takes these A's and B's. So you only get the chorus once in its ABAB form. But to end, you get it in an ABA form. And to start here, you get it in an A form. So each of those letters lasts for four bars. And what he does now, actually, to get himself back into line with the 17th bar, is he supplements it with two middle bars. So we're at the 11th bar, right? That is in the chorus. Right? So there it is.
And then he cuts it shorter.
Yeah, exactly. Well, yeah, he removes it. Yeah, exactly. Now just imagine the magic got light to asses. Well, it's a little longer than that, because it's like,
yeah.
Now just imagine the magic got light to asses. Don't ask for your favorite rapper. So he added it by two bars, and he did this because he understands what I'm talking about. He knows that he can't rap for four bars, because then the listener will be lost, because they'll be in an unbalanced structural place. So what he does is he adds two bars, because those lines aren't in the real place. Right? There's no imagine the magic got light to asses. Because
yeah,
now he knows
it all up.
Yeah, because if he had it in the chorus, then the chorus would be too long. The chorus would be 18 bars, or the chorus would be fucking 10 bars. So like he plays with it, but only enough to make you go like, what the fuck was that? And it's awesome when you hear the whole thing in all of its glory. Back after 16 bars have passed, so now everything's cool. You with me so far? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So it's like you have to understand this inherent nature of rap. No, the inherent structure of every rap song in order to be able to manipulate it. Because, yeah, that was really cool. You call it augmentation, I guess. Yeah, because he's augmenting the length of his chorus. And like you pointed out, his second chorus is shorter. Because I'll real quick take you through all the choruses.
So if you were to change the instrumental during that part, could that make it work? Because I see some songs where... Yeah, absolutely.
And this is what I'm talking about. So actually, one thing we can listen to is... Yeah, because it's like... Yeah. Basically, yeah. And that's why I was telling you that the beat is so important here. Because it's like, yes, if you change the instrumental, then you can cut it short. Because actually, even like your man Logic does this, right? You know, in Growing Pains Part 2, he doesn't just start rapping crazy. He waits for the beat to drop, and then he starts rapping crazy. Because he couldn't do it over the beat he has. So, like, a good example, actually, is this, it's kind of random, but a random song, but I reviewed it for Hip Hop DX. So, this. Okay, because this actually is a unique beat because it lasts for 3 bars or 6 bars. I forget. But like I was saying, almost every other rap beat in the history of rap lasts for 2 bars or 4 bars. So because the producer, DJ Newmark, structured it in a different way, now the rapper can structure his words in a different way. And I'll show you real quick. I'll count it out real quick.
I don't just want money, time to get paid. Playing this game, I ain't trying to get made. I'm the type to turn lemons in a lemonade. I'm the type to turn.
Alright, so you hear how the beat is lasting for 3?
Yeah.
So now, actually, so what do you, actually, I'd be interested, what do you think the rapper does? How long do you think his chorus lasts for? Do you think it lasts for the normal number of 4 beats? Well, I'll tell you, the beat always repeats after 3 bars on this. So what do you think Slim Kid does?
Probably goes for 12?
Yeah, but a multiple of 3, right?
Yeah.
Because why doesn't he do 4 bars?
Because it would throw it off.
Yes, balance. Yep.
Time to get laid, foreplayed on my friend said him going to hell. Putting drum, got a bit, so we stayed up late night grind. I want to a different drum, got a base myself. Minds get made up, time that we stayed up late night grind. Till the bills get paid up, hard times trying to define what we made up.
So you were right, because it lasts for a multiple of 3, but the multiple is actually 6. But okay. No, I would still say you were perfectly right, because he could easily have done 12, right, if he just repeated it. So, exactly, your insight is perfectly correct and awesome, because it's like, yeah, if the beat changes, then it doesn't matter. So I'm trying to think of, like, another big beat change. I mean, it's not a tempo one. No, it would have to be a tempo one. Let me listen to the My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy song that Raekwon is on. Gorgeous? What is it? Cause Kanye flips the beat really heavily.
Got about 2 things, Cali boots and Benzes, counting up smoke in 1 cup, live as a red jag, a Louis bag, grabbing the blunt.
That's not really the same, because it's still the same tempo. It's just that the accompaniment changed a lot. I mean, you know the Logic Growing Pains part that I'm talking about.
Like the N-Words of Paris one, they changed the beat quite a bit towards the end. Like, Don't Let Me Get My Zone.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, exactly. Yeah. And I think that change is actually, and this is a lot more common one. Because the change is one from straight time to double time, I think. I would argue, even though the snares are on the 3, I would argue that this is a single, or that this is a straight time song, so you don't count it like this. I don't think you count it that way. I think you count it like this. But like you're talking about, at the end, he does flip it to a double time. Yeah, so I think you're absolutely right. And they do bring this kind of more sing-songy flow into it at the end, because now tempo is longer, which actually ties in nicely back to what I've been saying this whole time, that singing, you need more space, because pitch matters, you know?
Yes.
Don't let me into my zone. I know I'm about to...
Yeah, exactly. So, I'm trying to think of other big, like, flow changes. I mean, the Beast from the Fugees has a really interesting structure. I would have to look up what it is, though, because it's a little complex. Let me see if I can find my logic file of the Beast. Because of the Fugees song, yeah. Okay, yeah, yeah. 1, 2, 3. How many? Jesus. Wait, what? Okay, yeah. Because here's the thing, alright? Yeah. So let me just show you one more example and we can get back to it. Alright, The Beast. Another Fugees song. Alright, this is the start of the song. 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, Alright, let's see how long she goes for.
Illegal sales districts, handpicked lunatics, keep all restrictions, rich heretics, push knock, I take some mistakes, risks and frisks, fool clicks, roll bricks, but seldom get targets, private dicks, sell hits, life on no flicks, two chicks,
for
96, illegal sales districts, handpicked. Conflicts with 96 illegal sales districts, handpicked lunatics, keep all restrictions, rich heretics, push knock, I take some mistakes, risks and frisks, fool clicks, roll bricks, but seldom get targets, private dicks, sell hits, life on no flicks, two chicks, the 666 cut wig like Newt Gingrich sucks dick.
Alright, so Lauren only went for 6 bars, right? But how long is the loop on this?
I think it's 9?
Remember, everything's gonna be a multiple of 2, so it's probably 4.
Oh, sorry, the actual beat.
Yeah, yeah.
Word of up, y'all.
Yeah, it's 2. So yeah, so now the problem is that she's not out of step with the beat because her verse, let's just call it a verse, lasts for 6 bars and the beat lasts for 2. So now what she's out of step with is the normal length of a rap verse, right? So
yeah.
And so Wyclef is about to rap. So here are 2 options for you. And again, I want you to tell me what you think he's going to do. So he could rap for 16, but then he's at 22 bars long. And that, what's wrong with that?
The chorus is 18 or 10, you said?
Yeah, the chorus is 8. Chorus is 8.
8. Oh, okay. I mean, he could do it shorter instead.
Yes, exactly. And that is actually what he does.
Ball restrictions, rich heretic, sell hits, life on no flicks, two chicks, the 666 cut wig like Newt Gingrich sucks dick.
Meanwhile, the government brings Star Wars from Glock to Glock. COP has an APB out on Chewbacca.
9.
Mr. Mayor, could I say something in your honor?
10.
Yesterday in Central Park, they got the jogger.
Okay. 11.
Let's get the confusion straight and ghetto got
12.
The man behind the mask you thought was Batman's Bill Clinton.
13.
Soon retire. The roof is on fire.
14.
The bomb as it comes from Oklahoma.
15.
Serious. Mumbaya. On the mountain, St. John for me, Manhattan, help me, Ja Ja.
4. Right? So you're right. So even though Lauren went for 6, Wyclef did 10, and 6 plus 10 is 16, which is the normal length of a rap verse. So you see how even when they're like upsetting these things within the music, they're not upsetting the music itself. So like they can flip their flows by switching from one MC to the next, but they always work to preserve it. Actually, I'm interested now because I know this first chorus is only 3 bars long. And I'm interested to know three.
I can't sleep,
and then he goes.
Search me.
So I'm interested to see if he brings it back in. Oh, there she is. Sorry. Lauren, verse 3. Chorus. Chorus 3. Interesting. Okay, see, and this is what you were asking about before, verse 4. You were asking me if, Jesus, why? Okay. You were asking me if the beat could help, and the answer is yes, because this is what they do, actually. So the first time, what we just heard, I showed you how they still preserve the 16-bar even structure, right? The even number structure. Well, the second time around, they don't. Because this is how long, this is the first chorus. It's really an interlude because no one's saying anything. But right here.
On the mountain, sing it off for me, Manhattan, help me, Jaja.
Yeah, one, two.
Word of
mouth. Two. Three.
I can't sleep at night. You can't.
Right? So that chorus is only one bar. Or that chorus is three bars long. But what they did is reset the beat. And then all of a sudden, that awkwardness isn't there anymore because the beat itself has reset. And actually, I just charted it out in Logic Real. No, dog, just show me. No, fucker. So actually, after that three-bar chorus, Wyclef raps for 8, and then Lauren raps for 8, which is 16. Because you might have expected them to do 17, which would have made it 20, but they don't. They preserve it. So yeah, that's just an example of how what you're saying before is right. Again, what I said before, those were just more examples of make everything line up with the bars better, unless you change the beat itself. Did you have any other more questions?
No, I think that's pretty straightforward. I actually never noticed that with the Rap God and stuff.
Absolutely. I know that because I know the song really well, and I know that would happen because I know music really well. But again, like, anytime you hear a major change like that, just your money should 99% be on them making that change at a division of 4. Because that's just how the whole genre is structured, right? And again, it's like a fucking balancing act, right? Like, if rap wants to have really complex rhythms, then melodic rhythms, then the accompanimental rhythms of the beat have to be simpler, which means that they get repeated. But then if you listen to, like, a fucking, what's a good one? If you listen to, like, classical music... Then you just see that, like, the balancing act is still there, it's just shifted in another direction, where the melody and the accompaniment are more even with each other. You know, their importance is more shared. And so that is so that you can have these crazy, crazy good chord progressions, which rap kind of dispenses with. Because it's not about the chord progressions, it's about the fucking rap. The rhythms, you know? And that's what a lot of people don't understand. That's what a lot of, like, classical musician listeners don't understand when they come to rap. Like, when you listen to rap, of course you're not going to get fucking crazy chord progressions because then that would distract away from the rapper. So, I mean, that's pretty good. Did you have any more questions? Are you good? You want to hop off?
I think I'm pretty set. I'm just going to write on that. And there's one other thing.
Yeah.
This is just super short, but... let's see if I here. Actually, I don't have too much on that. I'll let you know when I...
Okay, yeah. But you're on a really good start here. Like I said, you flow really well from one to the next. Like, all of your changes are very natural and smooth. Even, like, you coming... It's really good. So, I would keep... the places where your different flows meet the same, but then build out from the middle of each section, because your transitions are so flawless and seamless. You, I don't even notice, you know, in a good way.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, yeah, have fun, man. Are you up to anything tonight, or?
Probably going to hit up the art gallery or something like that.
Okay, cool, all right, well, yeah, have fun. And you want to meet next Saturday?
Yeah,
actually,
good.
I can't do it this Saturday, because it's Easter, and I'm visiting my family. So you want to do...
Oh, it is, yeah.
Yeah, you want to do two Saturdays?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, no problem. All right, cool. Sounds good, man. I'll talk to you later. Peace.
Okay, see
you. Later.